Victor here. Now, I completely forgot to film an intro, but I want to set the scene a little bit for you guys. So this is in the Bahamas. I'm on a trip with my buddies Mike, PJ, Roger, and Posey. Now, the first thing you guys see us doing is my buddy Mike has that bucket full of chunks of sardines that we cut up, and we're using these sardines to chum up the yellowfin tuna that we found using the birds that we found on our radar. Now, we look for the birds on the radar, which are usually flying above these schools of yellowfin tuna. It's kind of a strategy where you got to cut off the birds and the tuna is to not spook anything. Enough talking, let's get to fishing.
Doesn't really matter, maybe it might help to do something.
So they'll find the chunks. Do they just rip it out of your hands?
Oh yeah.
Yeah?
And by the time you drop that line...
How long you let him eat? Oh, I'm on.
He's on.
I'm off.
Keep feeding the fish. You felt him pick it up?
I felt something, it got tight. Oh, Mike's on!
Woo! All right, me and more rods.
Yeah, took my chunk. That's insane that they eat this little piece of freaking... Yep, I felt them pick it up and just drop it. Dude, they picked that up quick. You got a mega, Mike?
Yeah, Cashman, you gotta go under. You gotta go under.
Yes. Come on, where are you going? I'm here. I'm at the boat. I need a gap.
PJ.
Give me a gap. Give me a gap.
Here, I got it right here.
Oh, it's yellow.
Oh, nice, dude.
Yeah!
That was mine.
Hand me a chunk, PJ.
Put a squid on, they both
gotta
eat on squids.
Oh no, right there. I'm on. Yes! Woo-hoo-hoo! Yeah! Hold on, yeah? That ain't no little fish. That's a real one. Dude, I'm in full.
What?
I'm in full.
It's pretty heavy drag.
Yeah. That's a real one. That was on a sardine chunk. That was like a 100-yard run. Finally got to put these 50s to use for what they're meant to do.
What's up?
Is he your leader yet?
Nope. No, I'd see color before I see leader.
Shark now, you're gonna be pissed.
Huh?
If you get shark now, you're gonna be pissed.
Uh-oh.
There she is.
Don't say it.
Nice.
Oh, no, it is a shark.
Is it?
Yep.
Come on. I hooked the shark or he ate my yellowfin?
You hooked the shark? Or he's holding onto your yellow? It didn't take off like a shark. It took off like a yellow. Oh, yeah.
Break off. There we go.
Little recap of our first drift. Roger ended up pulling hook at the boat, heartbreaker. I lost one. I think I had a yellowfin on based on the way it was running, and I think a shark ate my yellowfin and ended up getting hooked. Mike got one. He's the only one to land one on this drift. So now we're getting our sardine chunks ready for the next drift, the next flock of birds.
Oh, I just got eight. Come back. Yes! Wheel. There. Where are you going, tuna? Yo, yellowfins ever just shoot up top? Oh yes. No, like 15.
Dude, it went straight up. It didn't dive down at all.
I can get an eye.
Are they?
Hey, the shark. The shark.
After like 3 hours of absolutely no activity, we finally hooked up. PJ's got a nice mahi on the green avid on a ballyhoo. I had one on too, but it came off.
Oh, that's a nice fish, man. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No, you're good.
So we can go right to that box.
Yeah, we're bringing it right to him.
Oh my God, hey, there's a couple of them.
Is there?
Yeah, get some drugs. I don't want to just flop crazy dick all over the place.
You guys may not be able to tell, but it got pretty damn rough out there. So I don't know why, but video never does the seas justice in terms of how rough it is. And it made it for really difficult conditions in trying to find the birds. You know, you can't see them as well, and the radar just doesn't pick up the signals as strongly. So we ended up the day just picking up some dolphin on the troll. And, you know, we did not get a lot of reports of yellowfin tuna back at the docks. And as you guys see, I was really focused on the fishing aspect more than the filming aspect today. You know, it was my first yellowfin trip, so I really wanted to knock those out. Hope you guys enjoyed it anyway. Chef Vic coming back at you with another voiceover. Now, the first thing we're doing is making poke. For my poke, for the marinade, I'm using some soy sauce, some rice vinegar. And you guys, please keep in mind, I am not a poke expert. This is just my version. You know, I try to find the basic recipes on how to do things, and I put my spin, my take on it. Added some sriracha in here as well for some heat. Now, I also wanted something fragrant and something to really, you know, kick it up a notch. We got some fresh ginger going in there, but not too much because ginger is very, very strong. I don't want it to overpower my sauce. So gonna go ahead and add that to our wet ingredients. Now we got some cilantro, like I said as well. Very, very strong, so not too much. Gonna add our cilantro. Scallions, some good fresh scallions cut up into very little pieces. Gonna add that to our mixture as well. Now the next thing we got going in here is mandarin. See, this is where I'm kind of veering away from the traditional. You know, some people might like this. I like it in my poke. But you know, I really like to experiment in the kitchen, so we're adding some fresh mandarins as well as some little red grape tomatoes. These are nice and firm. They don't get too mushy in a salad. I like them a lot. But hey, the kitchen's all about having fun, trying new things, and that's how you get recipes, and that's how you learn and grow as a chef. That's how you learn what works and what doesn't work together. So we go ahead and add that into our little stainless steel bowl. Give it a quick little mix, and this is the wet ingredients. Now here is a beautiful piece of ahi tuna, rocking it like a baby. This is the yellowfin. As you guys might notice, it's a little bit white, and that's because we did not kill them immediately when they get in the boat, because you're so concerned with getting so many fish in the boat. That lactic acid builds up, and that's why it got that white color. So I'm gonna be making this yellowfin into steaks as well as our poke. So you guys saw me cut them up into nice big steaks for the grill, and I'm getting rid of this real stringy bloody line stuff off of the tuna. And those are the size pieces for our poke bowl. You know, you could do smaller or bigger. That's the size that I like for my bowl right there. You know, nice bite-sized pieces, and you want to make sure they're pretty uniform in size. And I used more of the tail section for the poke and the shoulder section for our steaks because of the sizing. Now go ahead and add this to our bowl. Add some sesame seeds. Love sesame seeds in this, very fragrant. Here are our steaks. Gonna go ahead and lather these up in some olive oil on both sides. Big, juicy, thick steaks that are not gonna fall apart on the grill. And I'm just doing these simply blackened. I love blackened tuna. You can't go wrong with blackened tuna on the grill. So go ahead and put blackened seasoning. This stuff right here, I love this seasoning. Put that on both sides. Now, to go with our blackened tuna steaks, we're gonna be putting them on a sandwich, and we're gonna make a sauce for this, which is just sour cream, mayonnaise, basil, garlic, very simple. And one thing I really liked about these catch and cooks is I'm learning all these new sauces and stuff. And you know, you kind of learn that it's mainly the same principles. You know, you got your acids, your fats. You just got to learn how to get the ratios right, and that's all there is to it. I almost forgot the avocado for our poke. You know, this gives it a nice fat content, and it's just another eye opener because you get that green in there. It's just juicy. Here are our beautiful, beautiful steaks going on the grill. One of very few fish that you can actually put directly on the grill. As you guys see, when you flip it, it does not fall apart. Tuna has a very firm texture, but it's easily dried out, so you gotta make sure you put, you know, a good amount of oil or some type of marinade on there. Take them off the grill and they look beautiful. Serve them a little bit raw in the middle. There's our poke. Now here is where some people might say, wow, your poke does not look that good because it's drowning. I did put a little bit too much liquid, and that's one thing that I'm trying to learn. You know, next time I would not put as much. Here is our tuna going on our ciabatta with a little bit of lettuce. We got that basil cream sauce, that delicious basil cream sauce, some tomato. There is our little poke with some fresh scallion garnish on top. And you gotta do it up, right, poke on the plate itself, and there you have it.
That was a very good job. That tuna, blackened tuna sandwich was fantastic. I ate two of those. The poke is delicious. Both really good.
Definitely make the internet jealous every time we have a meal. Feel really spoiled. Everything was fantastic. Just phenomenal, everything.
Mom?
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
That's something your grandma would do.
Not fishy.
Not fishy.
Is that what she says?
Always. Every single time. Not fishy. Since she's not here. Everything was really good. Again, Victor killed it on his sandwich with that sauce. The basil mayonnaise sour cream sauce was just perfect with the tuna. It was a really good flavor. The poke was really good. Everything was really good. I didn't get to go on this trip, unfortunately. Hopefully I get to go on one and catch elephants, but I'm so glad that I still got to eat it. It was really good.
Thank you guys and everyone at the table. And if you guys don't know, this is Brooke's dad for any new subscribers. This is Brooke's brother, Jed, and her mom, and there's Brooke. And if you guys don't know, I don't just do catch and cooks. Brooke does a lot of catch and cooks, just as many as me. And a lot of them are filmed in this kitchen right here. So you guys do me a big favor, go ahead and subscribe to her channel as well. It will be in the description box below as well at the end of the video. And look forward to a lot of catch and cook, guys, because we are going down to the Keys for 9-10 days, and it's gonna be on. So like I said, thank you guys for watching, and I'll be seeing all you guys, my land sharks, in that next video.